Here we have a lymph node with a nice, smooth, thin capsule and patent subcapsular sinus. And this lymph node is infiltrated by some type of foreign material. And here we have only residual islands of lymphoid tissue composed of lymphocytes. In between these islands of residual lymphoid tissue, we can see large and smaller multiple clear vacuoles. These vacuoles are both extracellular and intracellular, and here we have these multinucleated foreign body type giant cells and histiocytes. These multinucleated giant cells are basically fused macrophages, and it is a typical reaction of macrophages when they can't get rid of the foreign material. Look what we have here. This is an asteroid body, which is typically seen in sarcoidosis, but also we can see this inclusions in case of foreign body type granulomatous reaction. And let's take a look at this cell. When these vacuoles are located inside of the cytoplasm, they can even cause indentation of the nucleus, and they can mimic lipoblasts. However, this is not a case of sarcoidosis, and not even metastasis of liposarcoma in the lymph node, because liposarcomas do not typically metastasize into the lymph nodes. This is an example of silicone lymphadenopathy. So the breast silicone implant may be associated with leakage of silicone material through the shell of the implant. Some of these silicone implants may also rupture. However, we can see examples of silicone lymphadenopathy even without a rupture of the implant, because some amount of silicone can get through the capsule even without a rupture. Most of the silicone material was dissolved during tissue processing. But here and there, like here for example, we can see some residual silicone material, which is refractile but non-polarizable. So if you take a look at this slide with a polarization filter, you wouldn't see any polarization of this foreign material. And this is another case where we see the skin of the breast with epidermis made out of stratified squamous epithelium with some hair follicles and sebaceous glands here. And the dermis is occupied with a similar multiple vacuoles. Some of them are large and extracellular, and some of them are small and intracellular. And again, here we have these multiple macrophages, and some of them are associated with indentation of the nuclei, which can be quite misleading. So there is no wonder that these cases may be easily mistaken for liposarcoma. And clinical information is very important. Thanks for watching.